I'll do a little safety stuff there, okay, sir? A little safety thing. Sir, you're on the end down here. Sometimes I miss, okay? I just want you to know that. Well, I'm trying to tell you, sir, watch everything I do. Okay? You ever seen that tennis match where they go? You see this guy right here? He might be a very inquisitive kind of guy. You know what? They never, when I'm looking at them, they never ask me a question. Never. Just when I start to throw it out, they say, hey, I say what? See? You weren't looking, sir. I could have had you. You were looking, weren't you, ma'am? That's right. Just remember, they don't let me catch these fish. Okay? And they're biting like crazy. So anything's going to bump into my line, young man, I'm going to set the hook, okay? Got it? Okay. Just making sure. I warned him. All right. Oh, sir, if it does happen, and I just have to hook you, will you do me a favor? Will you fight? Faith to me, it's all about the fight. You know it? I like to fight. All right, guys, how many of y'all like to fish? Good. How many of y'all like to catch lots of fish? How many of y'all like to catch a lot of big fish? How many of y'all do it? That's what I'm talking. Only the ladies raise their hand. You know why? Because they're the ones that catch the fish. I mean, really, if you want to catch fish, take your kids or your wife with you, and I guarantee you're going to catch fish. There's no doubt about it, because they can do it. All right. Catching fish. I never had a problem catching them, though. Really, I've never had a problem, ever. You know, the hardest part of my job was finding them. Buddy, you can find them, you catch them. I guarantee you. How many of y'all been to, like, Kill the Stream, the store over here on Katy? You all been there? How many, you know, sir, did you walk in there, you went to the fishing department, you went, saltwater on this side, freshwater on this side, there's about 5,000 different lures in there. 5,000 different colors. And you know what? Every one of those lures catch fish. Just some catch more than others, okay? Understanding how to fish them, very important, okay? Very important. First thing I'm gonna tell you, finding fish, anybody got a boat? You got a boat? You got a locator on it? Buddy, if they give me another one, I'd put that sucker on there. That's how much I like them, okay? Because they tell me what's going on down below. If you know how to read them, you can tell what kind of fish you are, can't you, sir? You can tell if it's a big old ball of shad. You can tell crappie, stacked on top of each other, aren't they? Bass are spread out. Catfish on the bottom. I mean, those are so easy. But, buddy, when you go along that bank, it's a totally different deal, isn't it? Okay, so that's why we got locator baits. This is my locator bait, spinner bait, crank bait, locator bait. Depending on how deep of water it is on a crank bait, it's going to depend on what crank bait I use. If it's in deeper water, sir, I'm going to throw a lip crank bait. If it's in skinny water, I'm going to throw a rattle trap. But if you don't fish rattle traps in Texas, you're something wrong with you, okay? All right. Spinner bait. First things I'm going to teach you about spinnerbait, blades. Very important. High sun, chrome. Low light conditions, go copper. Clear water, willow leaf. Muddy water, Colorado. Yep, clear water. I want flash. If I put a big old Colorado on there, I'm going to get vibration. Thump, thump, thump. That vibration is what they feel, okay? I mean, they feel that vibration, okay? Sir, how's the fish feel? And don't say slimy, because we all know that. Okay, I'm going to teach everybody something. You look at these bass here. You're going to see a big black line. See a big black line in the middle, sir? Look on top of it. You're going to find a real thin line. That's their lateral line. That's what they feel vibration with, okay? They see flash, they feel vibration. Next thing, color of skirt. If you're looking for fish, white chartreuse, chartreuse. Because you don't know what... You could be in clear water, you could be in muddy water, you could be in murky water. You got it? Clear, white, murky, white chartreuse, muddy, chartreuse. You can have other colors, it's okay. If you're out looking, because you're going to be covering lots of territory, people. The first thing you're going to do on an early morning, you better run up on a point, especially a point that's got a feeder creek in it. That feeder creek's been there forever, hasn't it, sir? What filled that lake up? Feeder creek. Those fish are gone, they've been there forever. Look, I live in a little town called Dark Corner, Oklahoma. I mean, it's small, okay? My great-great-grandfather lived there. My great-grandfather, my grandfather lived there. My dad, I lived there. My son and my grandsons lived there. You know what? We've lived there forever. Those bass have been there forever. So always think about that. Feeder creek, point early in the morning, and then start working your way back in the back, okay? All right, spinnerbait rod. This is a little 6.5 foot. Look here, look. This quarter ounce spinnerbait. I'm gonna use a quarter ounce spinnerbait. Why am I gonna use a quarter ounce spinnerbait? Because I can put the bait where I want to. This is a little loose bead stick. We call it a custom light. It's got a little tournament pro on it. It's a great little crankbait, a reel. And I want to be able to put the bait where I want it. See, the main thing about going down that bank is being able to do this right here. Right there by your foot, man. You feel that? Yeah, I can put that right where I want it. Every time, man, I can. I can put it right there on that, right there on your foot. See there? I can put it on your eye. I can put this thing just about anywhere I want to. Because if I'm going down the bank, I want to be able to do what, sir? If there's a fish splash back there, I want to... Sir, do me a favor, would you? Would you do me a favor? Open your mouth so I can show them how good I am with this. Crowd participation, sir, is all I'm asking for. A little participation. Okay. I'm really good, sir. I could hit his mouth. Look how big it is, okay? All right, girls, look here. Oh, don't do this when you throw a spinnerbait out. Everybody does it. You go. You get right by that fishy stump. You know what I'm talking. So do you know what a fishy stump looks like? You should. Yeah, you were. You go down through there and went, oh, look, that looks fishy. And so you do that, and then you splash, that fishy place ain't fishy no more. He gone. He's out of there. Okay? All right, next thing. They will strike this bait, they will not bite this bait. If you think a bass eats all the time, you're absolutely crazy. Look, sir, you look fairly intelligent. I've looked through the crowd. You ever seen anything like that swimming in the water by itself? Why would he eat it? You don't. Bait's a territory that strikes a kill. Pretty simple. If you don't set the hook when you hit the bite, you're gonna lose it because you're gonna spit it out real fast. Okay? Now I'll show you. These fish right here are hatchery fish. How many of y'all have ever seen one of my seminars? Guess what, sir? It's Saturday. Tomorrow's the last day. Guess what these fish are like? Piranhas. But they get fed every day, not by me. The guy that brings them, he throws that feed in there and makes them go crazy. And then every time they hear something fall in there, they go crazy again. If they'd leave it alone, they wouldn't do that. All right, here we go. Keep the bait low, guys. That's what I'm going to do. Keep the bait low. Watch. I'm going to bring the bait. Look. Watch him. Watch him strike it. Strike. Okay, look. See? Oh, here they come. They're thinking, oh, I'm going to get fed. Here they all come. Look at them down here wanting to get fed. But see what I'm doing? Look, guys. Get close to that cover. Look. Come up and over that cover. Now, they might look at it, and they might strike it, but they're going to spit it right back out. I guarantee you, they will not keep it in their mouth. And the reason why, it has no taste. So do me a favor, put that, tell these people what that tastes like. I can't get no help from you people. Can I tell you what it tastes like, sir? Steel.
I don't.
Got a little rubber on it, got a little paint on it. It tastes good. But see, that's why a fish does that, okay? So it's perfect, good locator bait. Guys, you're working down the bank. Now one of the main things about working down the bank is to find fish. If you get 5 or 6 strikes down through there, because let me tell you what, that feeder creek, there's going to be all kinds of different cover. I mean, channel swings, mud flats, pea gravel banks, brush piles, standing timber, stumps, big old trees. I'm telling you, there are all kinds of cover in there. So you better have a bait for every type of cover, because each time, sir, you miss a fish, guess what? You got five fish you miss, guess what happens? You have five fish in there, maybe 10. You know? Well, you catch one, you might catch one, sir, two or three. Okay? Now, I remember where I got those strikes, and you should too. I would say every one of you who's ever missed a fish remembers where you missed that fish, don't you? 20 years from now, sir, you're going to go, I missed a big fish on that stump over there. When was it? 1972. It was early in the morning. I was using a rattle trap. It was bright and red. So guys, remember this. Cover is important to me. And so if I'm going to pick up cover, you know what my favorite piece of cover is? Wood. They're drawn to it. But my most favorite is that big old pine tree that's falling down in the water. Over in East Texas, guys, y'all got these big old pine trees, and they fall down in the water. And when they fall down in the water, a 30-foot pine tree is a condominium for a bass. I mean, there's thousands of them, it seems like, sometimes. So I've got certain baits for everything, all right? If I'm throwing a pea gravel bank, I'm throwing a crawdad. A mud flat. Where you find crawdads, sir, on mud flats. Pea gravel bank with chunk rock. Crawdad. Think about it. I mean, it's so important. Oh, let's talk about color, okay? This is important. Color. Never, ever, 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 ever go lure shop without your wife or girlfriend. Sir, you can laugh. You have no idea what pretty is, okay? You don't. I mean, look. Ain't that pretty? It's got some pretty things to it. I got some purple up here too, man. Got a little pink, something to match your shirt. I'm telling you. So look, guys, think about this. But if I come across that brush pile, I'm going to throw this bait right here. This is my brush pile bait. First thing I'm going to do when I got this brush pile bait, I'm going to have a big old heavy rod, 7.5 foot. Me, this is going to be a broomstick, people. I guarantee you. This is heavy action. I got about 30-pound fluorocarbon line. Big line, heavy line. Sir, don't look at me like that. Heavy line works. When I get that big fish on, I want him in. If I get him on, I want him in. I got a 3-aught hook. This is called the same thing. Or how many guys fish beavers? Anybody fish a beaver out there? Woo, I like a beaver, don't you? Look here, sir. Beavers cost $7 to $8, don't they? Yeah, this is called the same thing. Well, I mean, it's a beaver, same thing. $3. Got it? Yeah. Look at it, sir, and see if it don't look like the same thing. That's why they call it the same thing, sir, okay? Ma'am, I know you laugh, but sometimes the hard-headed fisherman takes a little while to understand, okay? You got one next to you there. You know what I'm talking about, don't you? Uh-huh. One thing they don't have is these, okay? Then don't laugh, sir. You don't either, okay? But it's the same thing, guys. There's only a couple of baits that I think that you should stay with this, with the manufacturer. One of them is the fluke. How many guys fish flukes? The fluke. You should stay with Zoom flukes. You should stay with Zoom lizards. You should stay with senkos. Don't buy another brand. That's just the way it is, okay? But some of these plastics that are hard plastic like this right here, it don't matter. Because they look the same, okay? All right, here we go. All right. Oh, my weight's on my bait. I don't want my weight going up and down my line. I don't want them to hit it. If they hit that weight, guess what's going to happen? You're going to get four strike. You're going to set the hook and say, I missed him. See, guys, if you put that little weight right down there on it, now this right here is called a gambler or a Florida rig. We just screw it down on there, stays on there. The bass has no concept of size. He'll hit you whatever, okay? Trust me, he has no concept of size. I mean, think about this. How many guys know what the state record of Texas bass is? The Texas state record bass. Anybody know? 18 pound something, 18 pound, 18 six something. Okay? And guess what it was caught on? Anybody have any idea what it was caught on? A crappie jig this big. A stinking crappie fisherman went out there and caught the state record. How many guys fish? How many people fish for crappie? Will you do me a favor, sir? Will you leave our bass alone? How many times have you ever done that, sir? Throw that thing down there and get a big bass. God, stop it. But they didn't care. As long as you put in the strike zone, they're going to eat it. Okay? Pretty simple. And here we go. Now, guys, I'm going to tell you something. Look at them. See there? They throw that feed in there, and guess what, sir? Look at them all come up here. They drive me crazy, okay? And you know, let me tell you what really drives me crazy, sir. They don't let me set the hook. I had a guy at the last seminar. I threw it out there, and he went. I threw it out there again, sir. He kept doing it. I thought the man was going to have a heart attack. All right, here we go, guys. Watch. Oh, watch. Please, do me a favor. Watch eye fishing, okay? It's very important. Watch eye fishing. I really appreciate y'all. Not one of you watched how I fished it. Not one of you watched me, did you? Absolutely not one of you watched me. I said, watch how I fish the bait, and what'd you do? Let me tell you something, guys. I'm the star. They're just extras. They're not getting paid a dime to show you how to. What you're going to learn is how to eat. I want you to do me a favor. When you throw this bait here, I want you to follow it down. Follow it down, guys. I'm going to throw it in that brush pile. If I hold my rod up like this right here, it's going to go away from it. Follow it down. It's going to go. When you follow it down, look. You follow it down, guess what? That's what it's going to do. It's going to go right straight down. But if you hold your rod up, it's going right back at you. And you're going to lose. It's not going to go in that brush pile. And you're going to say this. Man, that looked fishy, but there wasn't one fish in there. Well, there was. You just didn't go in there and get it. All right? Alright, here we go, sir. Going on down the bank. There's my favorite thing. That old big old pine tree falling off in the water. Biggest bass ever caught on Rayburn was 11-2. I caught in a tournament. I caught it up in the fingers. Anybody know where Rayburn is? You know where the fingers are. First finger, sir. There's a big old pine tree that fall down in the water. 30 footer. I seen that thing. And I watched it and I said, oh yeah, okay. Now, I went out to have my amateur partner with me. He said, well, let's go over and see if we can find the end of it. And I said, well, it's about 7-8 foot of water. If I go over and try to find the end of it, I'm gonna scare anything off on there, right? He said, well, how do we know where it's at? All right, guys. Not smart. Not hard, is it, sir? Got a 30-foot tree, another one out there. Look at it. Oh, there it is, right there. And throw it out there at 11-2. The end of the pine tree, the big end of that big pine tree is where all the water, those little small branches are. That's where that big fish is going to be, up underneath there, or on top. He's going to lay in there. And I'm going to throw a senko. My favorite bait of all baits is a senko. I love this bait. My wife thinks I love it more than her. I love my wife. Man, I love my wife, okay? But I've made $500,000 on this bait in my career. So I like it a lot, okay? Yeah. This sounds like a lot of money, doesn't it, sir? You know it costs me $80,000 a year to fish the circuit? Yeah. You do the math, 38 times 80, I'm a little behind, okay? How many of y'all fish senkos? Boy, do you like the senko? Do you like Rayburn? Let me show you a new color for Rayburn. I'm going to tell you what, guys, if you fish Rayburn, you better have a red rattle trap. Rayburn red. I don't know why, everybody always talks, Rayburn red, Rayburn red, Rayburn red. Look here, sir, look, Rayburn. Look at that color. Sir, you back now. Goofy crappie fisherman back there. God, you drive me crazy, okay? So that's Rayburn Red, isn't it? Well, they don't call it that. They call it tomato seed, but I call it Rayburn Red, okay? Because I think it's going to work on Rayburn. All right? And guys, you don't have to have a weight with this one. You can throw this in the country mile. I'll do it that goofy crappie fisherman back there, okay? He's on the back row. All right? See, I don't usually talk about guys. It makes I think I can outrun them. I think I can outrun him, okay? I don't think I can whoop him, but I think I can outrun him, okay? All right. Man, I know you already got one. You give that to somebody else, that'd be really nice. Thank you very much. All right. Here we go. This is a new color, too, called South Africa. Man, look, you're going to talk about pretty. Look at this. Ain't that pretty? It ain't got no maroon in it, though, does it? Thank goodness. All right, here we go. You're not. Thanks, Amy. Okay, good. I was going to make sure. I got a brother-in-law's A&M Aggie. Hey, let me tell you something. Every one of my kids have gone to OU. They do that whoopee song. You know what I'm talking about? Okay, guys. Great rivalry. I love college football. That's one of my favorite things. If I'm not fishing, I like to watch college football, okay? Here we go, guys. All right. South Africa. Be out new colors all the time. Change my rod again. 6.5-foot beam, heavy action rod. 20-pound fluorocarbon line. Stick the big fish. Get him out. This is a big fish bait. Trust me. Big fish bait. How many guys get the Bassmasters magazine? In the back. You see the liars board. You got all those guys that hold that big old fish. At least one, two, maybe three of them caught on senko. All right? Okay.
She had rigged out with over $1,000 in accessories or a wreck paddleboard rigged with the cooler, tackle rack stand, and paddle for Fishing Tackle Unlimited. Stop by Fishing Tackle Unlimited at space 718 to register for your chance to win.
Thank you. All right. Big fish. Heavy line, big fish. Okay, we're going to get, okay. Oh. The reason why I'm always talking about heavy rods and heavy line is because I want you to catch the fish. You get the fish on, get him in. I've said that how many times today, haven't I, sir? Get the fish on, get him in. It's kind of like this. How many guys have ever caught a big bass? How many guys ever lost a big bass? Which one felt better? Which one could you take the picture of? You can't do this. Yeah, look, see that right there? That's where I missed a big bass, right there on that little stump there. Okay? That's because you didn't have heavy enough line. Senkos work. And I throw a 2-aught wide gap offset hook in red. Why red? Man, why red? It's pretty. Man, it's okay to be pretty, isn't it? Yeah, it's okay to be pretty. Tell him it's okay to be pretty. Yeah. Red hooks. They see it faster, sir. That's all I care about. They see it faster. All right, here we go. I'm going to throw this out. Whoever gets it, take one and pass the rest of them around. If you get it, take one and pass the rest around. Got it? Dude, sir, knock him out of the way. You should have dove for it, man. Yep, there you go. All right, here we go. Oh, where are you going to put that Triton boat with that mercury motor when you're fishing that? How are you going to position it? I'm going to position it like this so I can fish both sides. I'm not going to do this, throw it like this all the way down. I'm wasting time. I'm going to take that Triton boat and I'm going to do this right here. I'm going to put it right down through there. I got both sides of that tree, don't I? I don't know which way that bass is turning, so I'm going to make sure that I'm going to hit both sides, okay? All right, another good thing about the senko is this. When they put it in their mouth, they do not let go. This has salt in it. It's impregnated with salt. That's why, sir, you don't have to have a weight. Do not throw this to the weight. Throw it out there and sink. It's called the senko. I told you throw out jerk, it'd be called the jerko. I wish they called the fluke the jerko. So you would know. But they don't. All right, here we go. Y'all like to have a fishing pole like this right here. Wouldn't that be fun? Tell you how long that would last. But guys, really, throw it out in that sink. I love this bait. I really do. It's so easy. So easy to fish. Just throw it out in that sink. That's it. Bring it to me. Bring it here. Alright, now let go. Let go. Let go. Let go. Thank you. Just like my kids, they don't listen at all, sir. You know? Alright, all of a sudden, guys, I'm after a big bass. Oh, let me tell you something real quick. You got kids? Do me a favor. How many of y'all buy that big old tackle box for them like this right here, and they carry it like this right here? This is called a lure book. So cool. You put everything you want in. It's got a, this has already got loaded up. This is for pan fish. I got about, you know, got one. They make one for crappie. And they make one for black bass. Make one for walleye. But see, they can both fold it up, put it in their pocket. And they can go fish. Okay? Oh, real magic. Gotta have this. Better have this, guys. Every one of you. If you don't have this in your boat, you're making a mistake. This should go on your line. Softens your line, takes care of it, cleans it, takes all the gunk off. Sir, you're in the back of that creek back there. It's got a bunch of crap on the top of it, doesn't it? Where's it gonna go? No, don't do this. Don't start dumping your water. God, it drives me crazy. R-E-A-L, not R-E-E-L. R-E-E-L goes on the reel. R-E-A-L goes on the line. It softs it. It dissipates. You spray it on you if you want to. All right. Last but not least, I got. That was my time. I got to start. They only let you. Can you make? They say you can only talk for 30 minutes. Who's gonna tell on me? Big fish, guys. I'm going after big fish. I'm gonna pull big bait. Pretty simple. Big fish, big bait. I know I said that crappie jig caught the state record, but I'm going to tell you something. They will absolutely see this faster than they will a small bait. They'll hit the big bait, but they'll see this faster. This is called a hardtail worm. I changed my rod again. This is for swim baits. It's a swim bait rod, okay? We have rods for everything. Every fisherman, listen to me, the most important thing about my seminar, and guys, I say this in every seminar I've done, for, I guess, I've been doing this almost 35 years. Every seminar I do, I tell people this. It's a very important thing. These guys have probably heard it, but I want to really hammer it into you. Every fisherman, now listen, every fisherman should have at least a minimum of 40 rod reels, and that's just the start. That's just the kind of... Boy, it drives me crazy. How many pair of shoes you got, ma'am? Ooh. That's the shut-up look, isn't it? That's what I like. That's right, sir. I know. I got one just like her, okay? Woo! Gosh, I love it. Here we go. This ain't gonna go very far either. Watch them. Come on, buddy. Come on, bring it to me. Bring it fast, back. Yeah, he sucked that thing down, didn't he? Now, did you see how fast he sucked that thing in? Even when he was going, coming back, he went, bit it on the end, and went, that's what, and he got my stinking tail. And a sorry bum. That's not funny, ma'am. All right, I got one other thing I got to talk about. When you buy those rods, guys, do me a favor. Buy your sleeve. Listen to me, this is so important. This is a $175 rod right here. Broke it off. 6 inches off of there. That 6 inches is my fast tip. I get them free, I know it. It still bothers me to lose a rod that I've been using for a long time. It feels good to me. This right here, I'm going to put a new tip on it, sir, and it's going to be a catfish rod, okay? So it's not going to do me any good. You buy your new rod, guys, and you're going to spend you some money on it, put your rod sleeve on it. So important. Because you knock one of those little ceramic eyes off in there, it's gone. You catch a big fish, and you get that on, and that ceramic eye is gone, all it's going to do is fray your line. It's going to, you're going to break off. Okay? All right. Anybody here been in the military or is in the military right now? Anybody? Thank you for your service to our country. Anyone else? Thank you for your service to our country, sir. We live in the greatest country on earth. We are free to do whatever we want within the law. But we don't get that freedom from Washington, D.C. We get it from the men and women of our military, both past and present. You think about that, okay? I was afforded the opportunity to fish for a living out of a boat. It was because that guy and that lady right there gave me the opportunity, freedom, to do it. I don't take my freedom lightly, man. I appreciate it. I guarantee you I do. Next time you see a guy that's got a hat on and says he's a military man, walk up to him and shake his hand and tell him, thank you for your service to our country. And he'll probably tell you what, sir, I'd do it for you again. That's right. That guy and that lady right there stepped up to the plate. So that means a lot to me, okay? Now, how many of y'all think I have a great job? I do. I got one of the greatest jobs in the world. Sir, I've never had a regular job in my life. Well, I grew up on a farm, so I guess I did work. But, you know, I graduated from college. I went fishing. I put 5 kids through college. I've been all over the world fishing. But I have to thank the good Lord because he gives me the opportunity to do something I really love to do. Guess what? I get to do it for a living. And I give him the praise. If you think I'm stepping out on a limb when I talk about him up here, you're absolutely right, I am. But guess what? If it breaks, I know who's going to catch me. Do you? You should. All right, I'm going to get off here. Listen. Oh, I got some products down here. They are for sale. All the proceeds from these sale of these baits right here will go to a needy family, which is mine. Enjoy the rest of the show. Thank y'all. Thank you, thank you, thank you.